God this evening, and we're turning to 1 Corinthians, please. And we're in 1 Corinthians, and we're in chapter number 2. 1 Corinthians, chapter number 2. And I'm just going to read one verse. And Paul is writing in this verse. And 1 Corinthians, chapter 2, and it's verse number 2. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, and it's verse number 2. And Paul writes, and this is what he says, "For I determined not to know anything among you save Jesus Christ and Him crucified." That was Paul's message. His message was Christ, but not only Christ. His message was the cross. Because that's the gospel tonight. You can't have the gospel with no cross. Because the cross tonight is the center, is the heart of the gospel tonight. Jesus Christ and Him crucified. It was Easter Sunday morning, the 15th of April, 1990. A lady whose life was broken, terribly broken by sin, entered Christ Church, Church of Ireland in Lisburn. For many weeks, months, she had tried desperately to put the pieces of her life together. She almost had her life complete when she realized that there was one piece missing. She said that it was that one piece that was missing, was the key piece that would hold her life together. And because there was that missing piece, her life, wrecked and ruined by sin, kept falling apart. Well, this Easter Sunday morning, the 15th of April, 1990, this lady entered Christ Church, Parish Church, where she heard the rector preach, and heard the rector preach on the cross. For the first time, this lady, whose life was broken and ruined, heard that message that morning as the rector preached. And he pointed his congregation to the nail prints in his hands and said, "Those pierced hands of the Lord Jesus were pierced for you." He says it's those pierced hands that can make your life whole. And then he came down to the Savior's feet and said, "Do you see His feet that were pierced? Those feet were pierced for you. And those feet bring the Savior to you right now. And those feet bring the Savior close because He wants to meet you at your need." That Easter Sunday morning, 11:15 to be exact, this lady whose life was broken and ruined saw for the first time love so amazing, so divine, She says, my life was in pieces, but my heart was in smithereens when I saw by faith the Lord Jesus crucified on that cross, all in love for me. And on that Easter Sunday morning, 11:15, that lady in Christ Church Parish Church in Lisburn bowed her head where she was and asked the Lord Jesus to have mercy upon her and to save her soul. And that Easter Sunday morning, 11:15, for the first time, her life was made complete. Do you know what she told me in the all morning I was speaking during the phone? She says it was the old rugged cross that made the difference. Christ Jesus on that cross broke my heart of sin. That lady that I'm referring to is the well-known gospel singer. Her name is Amy Roberts. You know, it is no secret what God can do, what He's done for others, He can do for you. And I want to take that text tonight, Jesus Christ and Him crucified. You can't divide it. It's the part of the one message. You cannot just preach Jesus Christ and not preach Him crucified, because that's the gospel tonight. Jesus Christ and Him crucified. Tell me someone tonight, dear unsaved friend, Jesus Christ and Him crucified, what does He mean to you really? As I point you tonight to Jesus Christ and Him crucified, I want you to see Him first of all as the sinner's substitute. You see, people think tonight that sinners are bad people. Sinners are only those who smoke and drink. People today think that sinners are only murderers and thieves. Well, the Word of God says tonight, we're all sinners. You know, dear friend, this evening, before God tonight, if you're not saved, that's how you stand before God tonight. You don't stand before God as a Protestant. In God's sight, there's no such thing as a Protestant. In God's sight tonight, in God's sight, you're a sinner and you're lost. But Jesus Christ and Him crucified, I want you to see Him first of all as the sinner's substitute. Because you see, Jesus Christ and Him crucified, He was crucified on that cross because He was taking your place. He was taking your punishment. And dear unsaved friend, the Bible says in Romans 8 and verse 32, He who spared not His own Son, but delivered Him up for us all. You know, that's the gospel tonight. God knew that when His Son would come into this world, He would be taken and nailed to that old rugged cross. Because you see, God commended His love toward us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. An unsaved friend tonight, Jesus Christ and Him crucified, It was all for you. And it was all for me. John Griffith, in 1932, lost his job in Memphis, Tennessee. He was offered a job as the bridge tender over the Mississippi River. It was a bridge where it opened up to let the boats through and then came down again. It was a railway bridge. One day, John Griffiths, wee lad, wee son, 8 years of age, said to his daddy, he says, "Daddy, will you take me to your work one day, someday? I'd love to see the train." And John Griffith took the wee lad and brought him to his place of work. And of course, wee lads, as wee lads are, they're always curious. And as John Griffith was checking the, as he was checking the timetable, he then switched on the machine to put the bridge up, and the bridge went up, and the boat was sailing through. Just before he put the bridge down, he didn't see where the wee lad was. And he searched frantically for him. And he went down to the wheelhouse where all the cog wheels were. And there he was, pulled into the machine. The father didn't hear the wee lad scream. And the wee lad was screaming, "Don't let me die, Daddy. Don't let me die. Don't let me die." The train was coming in the evening, and it was about just 2 miles away. Over 400 passengers on it. And John Griffith desperately tried to get the wee fella out, but of no avail. It came, he could hear the train in the distance. He went back up to the control tower. He had a choice to make. It's either that train, them people, or my son. He ran down the stairs again to where the wee lad was, and the wee lad was crying frantically. And the father knelt down and kissed him, and his tears run between his lips. Tried one more time to get him out, but no. The father went upstairs. And as he saw the train coming, he knew a great catastrophe was about to happen. John Griffith did something that I couldn't do. He turned the machine on and closed his ears. And the bridge just came down in time. And he went outside to the platform where the train was going to go past and held up his wee lad's jacket and said, look what I have given to save you. God's bringing the cross before you just now, and he's saying to you, sinner friend, look what I have given to save you. I have given you my son. You're on the train of sin tonight. And you're in this meeting, you're on the train tonight that's leading to hell and leading to destruction. But God allowed his son to die that you might be saved. Jesus Christ and Him crucified. He's the sinner's substitute tonight. He died to save you. God spared not His Son. God spared not His Son, but allowed Him to die that you'd be saved. Saved from a lost sinner's hell. Oh, we're all moved and touched by the illustration, and that's a true story. How come we shed no tears for the Savior who died on the cross? Jesus Christ and Him crucified, the sinner's substitute. Jesus Christ and Him crucified tonight. Do you see Him? That's the sinner's sin bearer this evening. Jesus Christ and Him crucified is the sinner's sin bearer. You know, the Bible says, dear unsaved friend, He, His own self, bore our sins in His own body upon the tree. Bearing shame and scoffing rude, in our place condemned He stood, and every sin that this world would ever commit. Remember what the Bible says, the Lord laid on Him the iniquity of us all. Jesus Christ and Him crucified meant this, that the Lord Jesus, who knew no sin, would be made sin. He would become as the world's worst murderer. Jesus Christ and Him crucified would mean He would tonight become the world's worst adulterer. Jesus Christ and Him crucified tonight would mean tonight that He would become the world's worst sinner in the eyes of God. Because you see, Christ died not for our sins only, but for the sins of the whole world. And Jesus Christ and Him crucified bore the wrath and the penalty and the punishment that God needed to pour upon our sin. And instead of us, it was Him. The curse of all curses was laid on Jesus Christ and Him crucified. Oh, it was 2012. I remember going to a wake of a young lad just 31 years of age, died of cancer. And the father brought me up to the bedroom where the young lad was lying in the coffin. I'll never forget the father's words. He looked into the coffin and he says, "Son, I would have gladly have taken your cancer. I would have gladly taken your place. And I would be gladly to be the one to swap places with you. But you see, it wasn't possible. I'm telling you, it broke your heart. There's one in the glory tonight. Jesus Christ, Him crucified, did what that Father wanted to do. Not to take our cancer, because there's something worse than cancer tonight. It's sin. He was made sin for us. that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. Jesus Christ, on him crucified, the sinner's substitute. The sinner's sin bearer. Jesus Christ, on him crucified, the sinner's sacrifice. Oh, why? The sinner's sacrifice. Who gave himself for our sins, that he might deliver us from this present evil world. The day when the Lord Jesus Christ was crucified, the law declared he must die. The law said, I find him a sinner. But the Lord Jesus Christ, and him crucified, became that sacrifice for you and for me. Jesus Christ on him crucified was the means tonight of how sinners and sin could be dealt with, and how sinners could be saved. Because you see, he died for our sins according to the scriptures. Jesus Christ, on him crucified, in those words and in that text, we can see the Lamb of God which taketh away the sins of the world. Finally, on this Easter Sunday evening, as we look at Jesus Christ and him crucified, not only do you see the sinner's substitute, not only do you see the sinner's sin bearer, not only do you see tonight the sinner's sacrifice, tonight I see the sinner's salvation. You see, neither is there salvation than any other. There's none other name under heaven given amongst men whereby we must be saved. Jesus Christ, and him crucified, is God's way tonight for sinners to be saved. I was sharing with the senior citizens the other Tuesday a wee story of a lady dying. She lived a life of sin. But on her deathbed, a week or two leading up to her death, she found the Savior. And peace flooded her soul. You see, that's what Christ does. And that's what Christ can do for you. A day or two before she died, the minister come in. And the minister said to her, I hear you've made this deathbed repentance. And she told him, I have. I don't know what this minister's theology was, but he said to her, do you mean to tell me your life of sin. That your life of sin has just gone like that. In a moment of repentance. Now the lady says, no, it hasn't. My sin hasn't gone in the moment of repentance. My sin is gone because Jesus took it out of the way by nailing it to his cross. And I bear it no more. That's what's happened. Jesus Christ and him crucified. That's the message that's still relevant for today. And that's the message, sinner, you need to believe. But never you mind the message. You get to the Savior. Get you to Jesus Christ tonight. The one who was crucified. Yeah. Glory to God. But the one who rose again. And tonight who is a living Savior. Jesus Christ. And him crucified. Was there for you. Let's bow in a wee word of prayer.